What's up, everybody? My name is Brendan, and this is BigBearB Creative. Welcome back, everybody, to another Friday landscape photography video. Today, as you probably saw in the thumbnail, we're going to be talking about something really important. That's about being eco-friendly landscape photographers. And obviously, as a landscape photographer, the thing we do is go out in nature, take photos, beautiful photos of nature, share it with people. But we can't do that if we keep trashing Mother Nature. So it's very important that we start doing as much as we can, as well as with everyone else. But it's very important that we as well do this because, like I said, it's our job. It's what we do. It's what we enjoy. And if we're just taking photos of trash, then it's not going to be that fun. So today I'm going to be giving you a couple different tips. More than a couple. We're actually gonna be doing 5 tips on how you could be better eco-friendly landscape photographers when you're out in the field, as well as 4 eco-friendly tips for when you're at home, in your studio, wherever it is that you guys do your work outside of being on, as well as 4 other tips that you could use for when you're at home, at your studio, wherever it is that you do all your editing and all that kind of stuff you do if you guys make videos, where you do those as well. So we're gonna be doing 5 tips for when you're out in the field and then 4 tips when you're at home or in your studio. So let's get started with those 5 tips. So as landscape photographers, we are gonna use a lot of batteries. So tip number 1 is to use rechargeable batteries. Don't just use the single use ones. Now, obviously most cameras or DSLRs, mirrorlesses, all that, they typically have a battery pack that you recharge. That's great, but we have a lot of equipment as landscape photographers and not all of it uses those battery packs. So like we use drones, the controllers for the drones, they typically don't have a battery pack. You have to use batteries, probably AA's, but there's that. Lights, remotes, all this kind of stuff that we use, they take batteries, so you need to have rechargeable batteries. The light is really flickering, not flickering, but changing today. It must be a cloudy day outside, or it is a cloudy day. I have been outside today. Yeah, so as landscape photographers, we have a lot of batteries. Now it's best that we actually, instead of using those single use ones that they run out and then you toss them, use some rechargeable ones. There's a bunch of different brands out there, some more expensive, some more a little bit cheaper. All just depends on your budget, but just go ahead and purchase those rechargeable batteries because you could use them over and over again. As the slogan goes for being green, you're gonna reduce, reuse, and recycle. You're gonna reduce the amount of batteries that you're purchasing, which is great. You're gonna recycle those by recharging those. And when they do end up not being able to recharge anymore, you can recycle them. So you're gonna be doing everything you need to do there by using those rechargeable batteries. Now, tip number 2 is a very common thing if you guys are into camping and hiking. You've heard this phrase before, and as landscape photographers, you kind of have to be into that as well. So you've probably heard this as well, but whatever you take in, you take out. So water bottles, you probably shouldn't be using plastic. You shouldn't be using them, not probably. You shouldn't be using plastic water bottles. But whatever you bring in that contains your water or anything else, make sure you take that out. Food packaging, make sure you're taking that out. The whole thing with whatever you take in and bring out is that you do not want to leave a trace at all that you were there. If you've left a trace wherever you were shooting, you failed this. You need to make sure that whatever you bring in, you're taking out with you. The 3rd tip for being an eco-friendly landscape photographer is don't just do it for the shot. Now, obviously, as landscape photographers, we want to get the best light possible, the coolest composition, all that kind of stuff. But if it means that you're doing something you probably shouldn't do, don't do it. So if you see a beautiful shot that you could get, but it's in a blocked off area, that area is probably blocked off for a reason. That could be either 1, to prevent further erosion of that area. It could be to let more vegetation grow back. Whatever it is, it's blocked off for a reason. So don't go trampling over there where you shouldn't be and cause more damage than what's already been done. And that same thing also goes for if you already have a perfectly compositioned shot in an area you're supposed to be, but there's this one little twig that's just peeking in on the side. Don't go over there and snap the twig. Leave it be, just like you left that area be that's blocked off. Leave it be, because again, you're gonna be leaving a trace that you were there and you're breaking something that doesn't need to be broken. It's doing its job out there. So just slightly change your composition and shoot from there. You will probably end up with a better one anyway. So make sure you guys are doing that. And along those same lines of treading carefully, don't go into the area you're not supposed to. The 4th tip is to pack light and tread carefully. Because again, landscape photographers, we have a lot of gear. But to be eco-friendly, that means we don't need to bring it all with us at the same time. Like every time we go out, we don't need to bring everything. Only bring what you know you're going to need. And if you watched my video on best lenses for landscape photography, you know you only need two. You guys can check out that video if you're curious on what two lenses. But the same thing applies for all the rest of your equipment. Only bring exactly what's necessary. If you think you might need it, but you might not, go ahead and leave it. Because you probably have something else that's already in your bag that's going to do the same exact thing. So just pack light, because that's going to mean if you set your bag down, if you're setting up your tripod, you're not going to be harming the vegetation that's there. You're not going to be eroding anything like that. So you just want to make sure you're packing light and treading carefully. Because too, if you have too big of a backpack and you're walking through a forest and you're just swinging around, you might end up killing something, marking up trees, anything like that. It's not supposed to happen. It's not supposed to be there. Again, you want to make sure that you're leaving without a trace of you ever being there. And then the last and final tip for eco-friendly landscape photography while out on your shoots, this actually is a little bit more for going to your shoot, but it's all about getting there, traveling efficiently. Now, landscape photographers, we love to meet with other landscape photographers and shoot the same areas. It helps us find better compositions and just have a fun time over there while we're out there. So a great thing you can do is to carpool with your landscape photography friends, because the less amount of vehicles that are out on the road, the better. And you know, we're in a time right now that it's kind of sad, you know, with the pandemic going around, but one of the silver linings, I guess you could say, this is that there's actually been a lot of eco good things happening. I'm not sure exactly how to phrase it, but a lot of good things happening for the environment. You know, we've seen dolphins return to the canals in Venice. I think you could just basically see the skyline in Los Angeles from out in the ocean, so that was pretty sweet. We've actually healed one of the largest gaps in the ozone layer, so there's been a lot of great things, and that's happened because people have been quarantined. There's been less people out driving, traveling, less planes flying, all that kind of stuff. So it goes to show that the less amount of traveling, less amount of vehicles out there, the better it is for the environment. So that's a way that you could correlate this to here, is that when you carpool, you're going to have less vehicles out there, lowering the pollution. Now, if carpooling isn't an option for you, if your landscape photography friends live further away to where you can't really carpool and you typically just meet at those locations, then a great thing you can do is to look at your own personal means of transportation. Is your vehicle fuel efficient? Does it have good gas mileage? Do you drive a hybrid? Do you drive an electric car? Any of these are going to be a great option and going to be much better than that gas guzzling, pollution spraying car that you might have, or a car that you think you might want to get. Just go ahead and get a better fuel efficient car. It's going to be a much better landscape photography tool or piece of equipment. I even had a video all about this as well. So again, you guys could watch that as well. But yeah, your vehicle or how you're getting to your shoot locations is a great way to be eco-conscious and to make sure that you're, I say eco-conscious because obviously if you're not driving an electric car, it's going to be a little bit not so eco-friendly, because again, you're still going to have pollution, but it's going to be a little bit more conscious of it by having less pollution go out. But again, I could probably do a whole other video on that. But yeah, so those are the five tips that we're going to have for when you're out in the field and you're shooting. Because when you're being an eco-conscious landscape photographer, you're going to use rechargeable batteries. Whatever you bring in, you're going to be taking out. You're not just going to do it for the shot. You're going to leave the blocked off areas blocked off and the twigs alone. You're also going to remember to pack light and tread carefully. And while you're on your way to the scene, make sure you're being as eco-conscious as you can, carpooling or just making sure your vehicle is more fuel efficient and spouting out at least the least amount of pollution that it can. So those are the five tips that we have for while you're out on the shoot. But like we said at the beginning, a large part of being an eco-conscious landscape photographer isn't just while you're out in nature, but actually while you're home in your studio or your actual home, or whatever it is that you guys do, you do your editing and all that kind of stuff, because that's a huge part of your carbon footprint. So I have four tips for you there as well. So the first tip I have for you is also a great way to save money as well. So if you have a large energy bill that you get every month, this is a great tip. It's also an eco-conscious tip or eco-friendly tip, and that's to unplug when you're not using something. Now, a lot of the things that we actually plug in that we use, they use phantom power. And phantom power is basically power that's being consumed when something is off or not in use. And a great way to tell if some object or appliance that you have is using phantom power is if it has a light on indicating that it's off, which sounds a little contradictory there. Like, it's off, why are you powered, you know? But a great way to fix that is to just unplug it. It's gonna actually lower your monthly bill because you're actually lowering the amount of energy that you're consuming, which is gonna be a lot more eco-friendly. So be more eco-friendly and save money. Great tip. We all like to save money. And then going kind of off of that whole thing was that tip number two is to switch to a more sustainable or renewable energy source. So depending on your area, you might have different energy providers, or your energy provider has various options for you to choose. So a great option for you to look at with your energy providers or energy provider is to see if they have renewable energy sources, meaning wind, water, solar, geothermal. There's a bunch of different options, but see if they have a eco-friendly renewable energy source, because that's going to be a lot cleaner. However, if you don't have those options, if the only options your energy provider or providers offer is coal, oil, gas, or natural gas, some of these are going to be a lot more worse. Some are very toxic for the environment, some not as, but still not good. A great thing that you could do or to look into is to make your own energy source. See, look into adding a solar system to your roof that would help you power your either your studio, your home, anything like that. It's a great option. There's also, you can do wind turbines, all that kind of stuff. So look into your other options. Plus, a little pro tip for that. Some, and depending on where you live again, if you have a solar system and you're producing more energy than your home actually consumes, if you send that back to your city, you actually get, I believe, tax write-offs, or maybe they write you a check or something. I will look into that. That's another great option, because again, more eco-friendly, possibly saving or gaining money. So that's pretty cool. So look into that if those eco-friendly options for your power aren't an option for you. And then that leads us into our third tip, which is the slogan of being eco-friendly, which is to reduce, reuse, and recycle. Even while you're home in your studio, you need to be reducing what it is that you're buying, what you're consuming, because a lot of the times we buy more than what we actually need. Landscape photographers, we're really bad at this. I've talked about this in that lens one. We typically have like 18 lenses, but we really only need two, maybe three. But it's just the thing we do. We buy more than what we actually need. So a great way to be more eco-friendly and to be an eco-friendly landscape photographer is to just buy less. And what you do need to buy, make sure that you can reuse it or try to reuse it as much as you can. There's just a bunch of different ways that you can reuse items that you may only think is a one-time use that you typically throw away, but you could actually end up reusing for various other things. Now, if you've reduced as much as you can, you've reused as much as you can, but you have to get rid of something, try to recycle it as often as you can. The whole goal of this is to send as little to the landfill as possible. And if you end up sending none to the landfill, then you're doing a fantastic job here. So like I said, just reduce what you're buying, reuse as much as you can, and recycle what you have to. And then again, don't try to send anything to the landfill. And then the last tip I have for you, tip number four, is to support sustainable brands. Now, obviously, like we said, landscape photographers, we purchase a lot of things, whether it's equipment or just things for our home, studio, decorative, anything like that. We purchase a lot of things. So the best way to be an eco-friendly landscape photographer is to support those who support you. So buy from brands that are sustainable, whether that means that the things that they're making are from recycled materials. So it could be like people that make camera bags, but they're making them from recycled plastic water bottles that we pull out of our oceans, or anything like that. That's a great thing that we could do. Or make sure that they're actually, the way that they send their packaging, or you could even make sure that the way that they send their material to you, their products to you, is in a recyclable manner that's eco-friendly and all that. And then the last thing you could do, the bare minimum that they could do, is to make sure that they support eco-friendly nonprofits in any sort of way, whether they team up with them to help support them, or they actually give donations, or part of your purchase to them is sent to them, anything like that. It's a great way to help clean up Mother Nature and to just, again, help out and be as eco-friendly as we can. So like we said, there's a bunch of different ways that we could be eco-friendly landscape photographers and to practice eco-friendly landscape photography, whether it's out in the field or in home, your studio, anything like that. There's a bunch of different ways you could help. And doing any of these that we've listed today is a great way to begin. It's a great way to start. There's a bunch more you could do. If you guys really like this kind of video and you want to know more eco-friendly landscape photography tips, I would love to make more videos for you guys. So let me know down in the comment section below what your favorite tip was. If you have other tips for people, because the more we can inform others, the better that we could be for Mother Nature, and also the healthier we can be too. So make make sure if you guys have any other tips, if you like some of these tips, let me know down below, let others know down below. And also, if you like this video, make sure you guys are bear pawing that like button. We do these Friday photography, landscape photography videos every week. And as often as I can, I give you guys a little bonus Sunday video. It's typically about, it is landscape photography. I don't know where I said or, but about landscape photography photo editing. That we'll go over to my computer back there and I'll show you how I edit my photos and all that. So make sure you guys are subscribing if you enjoy this kind of content. And if you also like some other things, it's not just landscape photography, but are also eco-friendly, I suggest you check out a link down below, bigbearbcreative.com/ecoapparel. That's where you can find this shirt and a bunch of other ones that I've designed. It's not just shirts, but they're all printed on eco-conscious material. So you can find yourself a t-shirt, long sleeve, hoodie, even tote bags for being an eco-friendly shopper. And then stickers, they aren't eco-friendly, but we like stickers. So if that's the least amount of things that I'm sending out that aren't eco-conscious, I'm okay with that. Just make sure you guys are recycling the backings if it is possible. So if, like I said, if you guys like to help support me by doing that, you could also be eco-friendly and doing the same thing. So you guys could check that out. This is my favorite one. It's a Aztec-y inspired nature shirt. It kind of has the sky go down to mount to even down to the ocean. So it's really cool. I suggest you guys check that out. And thank you guys for watching this video. Hope you guys have a great day. Be safe during this time. Start being eco-conscious and have a great day.